government on display. Jared's in the banking business. You got a new financial regulation bill called Dodd-Frank. They are telling every banker in America, regardless of size, how to run their business. If you're in healthcare, they're telling you how to run your business. In fact, no matter what line of work you're in, the single biggest complaint I hear, not only in our state, but since I'm Republican leader of the Senate, I move around the country a lot, and I've done some of that as well during August. Overregulation is the single biggest impediment to coming out of this economic trough that we're in. Who are these people overregulating? Well, Washington is a boom town. The rest of the country may be in a recession, but Washington's a boom town. We hired 150,000 new employees. We borrowed money that these young people are going to have to pay back. And they're busy crawling all over every business in America, telling them what to do. Born of a basic suspicion that if you're in the private sector, you're up to no good. And we're from the government, and we're here to help you. Tell you how to run your business. Now, what's your natural reaction when that happens? Well, you pull back. You say, well, there's too much uncertainty here. Because expanding employment means taking on additional expenses. So this overregulation has caused our whole economy to clog up. Too much spending, too much debt, too many regulations. All of this, and the threat of taxation, they want to raise taxes as well. So you add that all up, and we're just sort of sitting there. I read the other day that corporate America was sitting on about $2.5 trillion in cash, kind of uninvested, just sort of sitting there waiting to decide what to do. Now, what companies mainly like to do when they have cash is expand. They're in business to make more money, which, of course, hires more people and creates more jobs. But they're all kind of frozen up because of this overregulation. So what would I do if I had a chance to do it differently? Well, I'll tell you one thing. The American people, after looking at all this for 2 years, last November decided to issue what one pundit called a national restraining order. In other words, they changed the Congress. They changed the House of Representatives. They improved my position in the Senate. I had a mere 40 as Republican leader of the Senate in the previous Congress. We now have 47, which doesn't give you control, but it gives you sort of blocking power to make sure nothing really bad happens. But now they're wondering whether anything can be done. But you have divided government. Neither party controls the whole government. What, if anything, can be accomplished? Well, it's counterintuitive. You know, you wouldn't think this, but actually, frequently, divided government can do big things, important things.